Gabs, this Warhammer 40,000 Battle Report, playing on a Pinewood hillside this time. Got a lovely rolling hillside there, very high, and then the different woods, then coming across, got a winding road as you swing round, and it drops down into like a valley here with a very shallow, it's dried out riverbed, coming across golden statue. It marks the boundary of Imperial territory on this planet. There have been reports that a Tyranid force has landed, so the Blood Angels have been dispatched to deal with them. And then the road swings across and around and up and off the table here. Quite an impressive looking piece of terrain. Look nice as we square off Blood Angels against Tyranids. Welcome to our Warhammer 40,000 Battle Report. It is Blood Angels against Tyranids. So it is a grudge match between these two forces. If you remember on previous games, the previous game that we played, the Blood Angels were cheated of victory, really, by the Tyranids. The game ended on turn 5. But the Blood Angels are back, and I'll be in command of them. It's the first time, really, I've used them on YouTube, even though it's my own force. My brother usually takes them, but I'm taking command tonight. So heavy support, Storm Raven gunship with twin linked multi-melter and las cannons, and then inside that is 5 assault terminators, all with thunder hammers and storm shields. Moving along, it's the death company. I hope they can get them engaged in the battle tonight. It's the Storm Raven gunship again, same loadout as the previous one, and then the death company dreadnought. And then 7 Death Company, 2 power weapons in there, and a Thunder Hammer. And they are being led by my Warlord, which is the Reclusiarch. No upgrades for him, just 130 points. Troops choice in a dedicated transport. It's a Land Raider, 2 Twin Link Las Cannons, and Twin Link Heavy Bolter. And it's just a standard squad of 5 Assault Marines, and then 5 more Assault Marines in a Razorback. No upgrades again. And then a heavy support of a Predator Annihilator with 3 las cannons. Nice choice, that one. And then we've dropped the Furioso Dreadnought. Reports have gone back that the Blood Angels have been humiliated a few times, so Brother Cabulo is in the force. First time I've ever used Cabulo. I look forward to using him. Nice figure. One of the old sculpts from years ago. But they're also pretty good. Look forward to using him and see how he does with his rending chainsword against the Tyranid scum. So, going to move on to deployment now, and then we'll go on to first turn. Right, this is James and Ben's Tyranid force. It hasn't changed. This is the force that took on the Blood Angels on the desert terrain in the previous game and stole victory on turn 5. So they're back again. It's the Tervagon, taken as a troop's choice. And then a Morlock, Trigon, and the 6 Raveners. And then the Hive Tyrant, Winged Hive Tyrant. And then the Warlord is another Hive Tyrant with 2 Tyrant Guard, Lashwhip Bone Sword and Strangleform Cannon. And then a Brood of 2 Carnifexes as the third and final heavy support. And then 2 troops choices, 2 units of 10 gaunts. And then as before, all the monstrous creatures have the regenerate upgrade. So on rolls of a 6, they'll regain wounds each turn. So that is the army. It's a game of hatred between these two forces. The Blood Angels seeking revenge for the previous humiliation. So we're going to deployment now. Right, rolled for scenario, and for the first time rolled a 6, so it's the Relic. Really nice, strong theme to the game. Have a Relic, and it's this banner here. Blood Angels are seeking to reclaim the banner, and it's just abandoned here on its own in the middle of the battlefield. So the Blood Angels have to reclaim that banner, and the Tyranids are wanting to keep it for whatever reason, but it's the... we've rolled for deployment. There is a central line of dice running up the table here from one end to the other. And then on the left-hand side, this is where the Blood Angels will be deploying. So they're coming along, deploying behind that second line of orange dice. So they've got quite a commanding view of the battlefield. And then to the right of the centre line here is where the Tyranids will. So it's an uphill struggle for them. You can see that from the bottom of the riverbed, they've got to advance up the hillside there. But really it's the relics, so they're just after that banner. So it's a rush for that. And Tyranids do have an advantage. They have a colossal bunch of a horde that will be able to advance and collect that. So Blood Angels have got to move fast. Almost like a snatch and grab scenario, this one. So we're going to go on to deployment now. Exciting game. Good scenario. Nice terrain. And two high-powered armies trying to fight it out. So we'll move on to deployment now. Blood Angels are going first, unless the Tyranids can steal the initiative. Right, Blood Angels deployment. Predator Annihilator's just sitting here. Look at the view it has down the battlefield. Excellent position for it. And then what we've done is we put the troop receiver side of the woods here. So you've got the ones in the Land Raider there, one's in the Razor back there, and they're both going to try and make a dash for the Relic. Now, problem is, he's got nasty stuff down there, so what we might do is bring on the transports, bring on the flyers, soften them up, fly up and over the top, charge in and push the Tyranids back, and then the troops dash in. That's the plan. Tyranid deployment is here. The Morlock's just sitting there. It's going to disappear on the first turn. And then the Hive Tyrant with a troops choice just there. And then the Turbogon with its rear end facing the Blood Angels in protest. But that's just there with another Gaunt troops choice. That's probably the closest to the relics, just there. And then the Carnifex Brood struggling for cover, really. They're in the open. And they're downhill. So it is a disadvantage of the Tyranids. But we've learnt from past games, you never underestimate them. He has got deep striking units. So the game will adapt and change as the turns progress. So the Tyranids have found to steal the initiative. Blood Angels are going to go first. So we're going to move on now to turn one. Right, reserves to the Blood Angels. The Storm Raven gunship with Cabulo. He's gone with the Terminators. So he's going to give them feel no pain. And then the second Storm Raven's flying on as well with the Death Company. And then those two units are in with their transport vehicles. And then for the Tyranids, the Trigon is in reserve. It'll be deep striking. The Ravenors will be deep striking. And the Winged Hive Tyrant will be flying on from reserve. Blood Angel turn one, it is night fighting, so under cover of darkness, the Blood Angels have moved out in a quick move. Land Raiders come up, down, and around and has gone flat out. We've done the whole turn here, there's no shooting, so we've done our run moves as well. And then the Razorbacks move, turned around, got out 6, and then run 4 inches, so we are now in base contact with the Relic already. So Blood Angels making a quick dash to grab the Relic, a sense of desperation from them, but they could claim that relic. That's good maneuvering. Just come around to show you how close they are. They've run and grabbed the relic whilst the Turbogon has its back to them. So they've sneaked up. How will the Tyranids react? We're going to move on now to Tyranid turn one. Right, Tyranid movement on turn one. Remember, it's still night fighting. Got unit of Gaunts just shifting around to the left. Don't know exactly why. But they are moving off. Hive Tyrants moving along here, just advancing up and over the hill. It's got a view to fire at the Assault Marines. Now, with Nightfire, you'll still get the shot off, just increasing cover save, so they are going to be targeted, those guys. Gaunt's just hiding behind the bank here. A unit of 13, no doubles, were bred by the Turbigon. So they're amassing behind the bank, well protected, and then the Carnifexes have advanced as well. So steady advance from the Carnifexes, pretty steady or standard game at the moment, but it would all kick off when the reserves start arriving, especially for the Tyranids with their deep striking Morlock and Trigon. So the Morlock has disappeared off the table, it burrowed down, so that will now appear on turn two. So that's the state of play on turn one. We're going to move on now to shooting for the Tyranids, see if they can whittle down the assault squad and do some damage. Right, shooting and run moves for the Tyranids on turn one. These guys have run around a bit further, so they're closing in. Hive Tyrant fired his Strangleform cannon and has caused two wounds on the assault squad. So he killed the front two guys. The sergeant holding the banner is still alive, so that hero sergeant's got the banner. And then we'll try and make an escape on turn two. And he better get a move on, because the Carnifexes have come up and over the bank with their run moves. So you can see the situation. Now it's Carnifexes chasing the hero sergeant. Turbigon rolled a six for run moves and swung around to the right-hand side. And then his Gaunt units are just hiding at the bank here. So that is the whole of turn one finished. Going to move on now to Blood Angels turn two. We'll see what reserves come on. Right, Blood Angels, here we go. We want to get these reserves on. So the first one, Terminators, are five. They are on. And the Death Company, it'd be great if they arrive on a four. They do. So the Blood Angels Air Cavalry has arrived. It's going to move on to the movement phase. So the Blood Angels now. Right, Blood Angels moving on turn two. The flyer with the Death Company inside is zoomed on here, over there, so it's in a good position to fire at the advancing Carnifexes. Second one has advanced and come on here, and that's got a view onto the Carnifexes as well. That's a priority for us at the moment. And then you'll see that the Predator has got a view to the Carnifexes as well. That's the priority to be destroyed, and good job with the Blood Angels with that heavy firepower that they have. Right, now there's a bit of explaining to do here. I had forgotten to do a morale check for the first assault squad, the one that came out the Razorback. I rolled it, got a 10, so we failed. It's typical. So then they fell back 5 inches, but my second troop's choice has come forwards, come out of the Land Raider, and the second sergeant now is in a position to grab the relic. But he better get a move on, because the Carnifex Brood is advancing forward. So it's priority level one, destroy the Carnifexes and the relic may be safe. So we're going to move on to shooting now for the Blood Angels. Night fighting's over, so we'll see how well they do. Right, Blood Angels shooting on turn two. It's well-coordinated firepower from the Predator on the top of the hillside there, and the two flyers and the Land Raider las cannons coming down, and they have killed the entire brood of Carnifexes. The whole two of them have been destroyed. So that's a good turn. That's first blood to the Blood Angels. And they hold the relic. So that's eliminated that threat, which is good. We've just got Turbigon down here and two units of Gaunts, but it's reserves coming on for the Tyranids now. So we're going to move on to Tyranid turn two. Right, the battlefield's got pretty lively now. Raveners have arrived here. That's where he wanted them to land, and they've turned up on the hillside. The Morlock was intending to burst up right through the squad with a banner, but found it scattered 10 inches back and has landed there. Looks good, but it's scattered a long way away. Would have been absolutely devastating if he'd landed on target. Gaunts have moved up round. Hive Tyrant's moved around. He's got a view to either charge the Land Raider or fire his cannon at the squad there. The Gaunts are up and over the bank, and have been breeding again. It's another unit's burst out, so there's loads of them now. And then the Trigon, he wanted to land right there, but he's scattered 10 inches back as well and has landed just on the edge of the roadside here. But it looks good. It's impressive amount of stuff in from the Tyranids, but will they get to that relic? The winged Hive Tyrant has turned up, it's gone 24 inches and is attempting to fly up and over the fly there, so it doesn't look pretty, but he can't really touch us at the moment. So the Tyranids are all over the place, as we predicted would happen, but the Blood Angels have got off lightly so far. It's going to move on now to Tyranid shooting on turn two. Decided the Tyranids don't want the relic, they just want to eat it. But it's all going bad for the Blood Angels at the moment. It's turning really bad, actually. We're going to tell you what's happening. You can see the winged Hive Tyrant has ran 2d6, 10 inches, and is moving across. Now, he's right in the heart of the Blood Angels' deployment now. So next turn, he'll be in a position to assault down any unit he wants. So, again, the Tyranids have done it again. They're bursting up all over the place and creating havoc amongst the Blood Angels. So, shooting for the Tyranids and run moves. The Ravenors have gone into the woods here. And the Morlock's quite happy to go where it is. Just going to sit there. It's in a commanding position on the battlefield there. You've seen already that the winged Hive Tyrant's gone 10 inches, flying across. There's Tyranids all over the place here. Nowhere is safe now on the battlefield for the Blood Angels coming round. Hive Tyrant fired at the side of the Land Raiders, intending to try and charge that. And then damage has been done by the Gaunts here, fired all of their assault weapons and have killed three Marines, including the Sergeant, Fowdy's lookout Sir Roll. And he's been killed, so the Marines here are dropping like flies. There's only two left, and they're not in base contact with the relic, so it's a real mess up. Plus, he looks like he wants to assault with the Gaunts as well. So, Blood Angels in trouble again as the Tyranids go on to their assault phase on turn two. Right, before we forget this, morale for those guys 9. No, hang on, Sergeant's dead. So, they run off as well. This is bad. And they go back 4 inches. Bad news for the Blood Angels. Gonna have to try and salvage this desperate situation. So the Blood Angels, now completely unnerved by the Tyranids, they rushed forwards to grab the relic. The brothers in battle have been slain, and the second unit has now fallen back, just those two men there next to the Razorback. So trouble for the Blood Angels, it's official. How are they going to salvage this situation? right, Blood Angels turn three. There's a fair bit of manoeuvring going on here as we try and rescue the situation with the Relic. First, Storm Raven gunships fallen back 6 inches and then deployed the Terminators with Brother Kabula. You can see him there leading the way. He's there by royal appointment to try and win the situation before the Blood Angels. A real nasty situation, but there is some confidence that we can deal with this Tyranid threat. So the Terminators have got out with Kabula and they're ready to try and assault the Morlock. Got to try and eliminate that unit and perhaps also try and get a charge in on the Raveners as well. Coming round, fire support coming in from the Predator Annihilator. It's got a view up the table towards the Trigon. Coming around the table. Right, trying to form a perimeter around the last of the troops' choices. The Land Raiders come forwards. And the Razorbacks come around the back. Just trying to shield the last of the troops. This is the plan. And then going to try and wipe out this Tyranid force here. So the Death Company have arrived. We've hurled them into the battle. They're going to try and take on multiple Tyranid units here as they charge in with the Reclusia. And then the Death Company Dreadnoughts got out as well. Gaunts is its favourite meal. It's going to dice up a whole load, hopefully, if we can charge in. And then the Storm Ravens try and get angles that they can support the ground troops and get some heavy firepower into the monstrous creatures at the same time. Can't deal with all the Tyranid units, but we can try and eliminate the main threats. So we're trying to clear a path. It's a case of a last stand in the middle whilst our elite choices come in to try and rescue and salvage the situation. So it's a critical point now. Blood Angels shooting coming up now on turn three. Right, Blood Angels shooting on turn three. It has been a spectacular display from the Blood Angels. So las cannon fire coming down and rocket fire and multi-melter and twin-linked las cannon fire destroyed the Trigon. And more firepower coming down from here destroyed the Turbigon, which then proceeded to blow up and has killed a whole load of its own gaunts. Horrendous casualties. And then James's units have fallen back. Two of them fell back. One off the table and the other one just here. So there's a huge hole. There were a whole load of Tyranids here and they've gone from a great display from the Blood Angels. Now the Death Company Dreadnought turned around and ran just an inch. He's trying to support or trying to prevent a rear end attack from the Tyranids on the hillside there, but he only shuffled an inch, so there's not much he can do about that. That's really all the firepower that came in. Las cannon from the Land Raider shot and did a wound on the Hive Tyrant there. So the game was really against the Blood Angels, and then probably the most dramatic turnaround that we've seen. The game has swung right in the favour of the Blood Angels. A lot of casualties on the Tyranid side, a lot of key units gone, but we'll see what happens. Game's still not over yet. Got to pick up the Relic next turn if we survive, and then try and protect it for the rest of the game. So we're going to move on now to Blood Angels assaults on turn three. Has gone well. The Terminators rolled a 7, so they've flown in through the woods. Well, not flown in, they've smashed their way through, but led by Brother Kabula there, have gone in against the Morlock and have made contact with the Raveners as well. So that's a good turnout there. And then coming around, the Death Company have reached the Gaunts, so it's going to be a close one.
In other words, they're dead.
The Gaunts are a tough unit.
Sorry.
So the Gaunts have got a fight on their hands. There's no cover there, so it's simultaneous initiative. We'll see if the Gaunts can take out at least one Death Company with them, but the Blood Angels, it's official, they are on the rampage in this game. Right, we're just doing this assault here. The Terminators are piled in. So you've got the Ravenous here, they're initiative 5, they've reacted first, they'll go first. But Kabulo's gone in, he's initiative 5, so he's going to do his attacks against the Morlocks. So we're just going to roll those up, see what we get. So weapon skill 5. Two hits, and we're rending. So we've failed to do anything, so Kabulo's done nothing. But he's going to grant that feel no pain to the unit, which is handy enough. So James is going to go first here with the Raveners, so see if they can take down any of these Terminators. So you're forced to hit with the Raveners. We're re-rolling misses. The Scything Talons. Re-roll the misses. Balls you wanted, so you drop them. So it's not bad, that's a fair amount of hits. And then you want fours to wound. That's good. That's good, can't complain at that. That's 9 hits on the Terminators. We don't want a whole load of ones. Right, here we go. 9 rolls. Don't get ones. Only one. Oh, that's good. And then a feel no pain here of a pass. So that's good going from the Terminators. They passed all of their armor saves there and the feel no pain as well. So just going to do the Morlock attack now. 4 up for the just one hit. 2's to wound, yes. 2 plus save. Ooh. So that's the Terminator down. And we're going to do a 5 up. No, so Terminator has been killed by the Avenging Morlock. So 1 kill there, but we're going to go on now to see how well the Terminators do. Right, Terminators now. These are the attacks against the Raveners. So we want 4s. That's shocking. And then 2s. So we killed 2, which is good. And then the Terminator Sergeant against the Morlock. He's got 2 hits and 1 wound. So that's the assaults done. So Blood Angels assaults the Death Company, killed the Gaunts, and just went an inch in consolidation just up in this direction, heading off to protect the Relic. The Reclusiarch can see the Relic. They've accomplished their mission and they're now heading off to protect them. The Morlock took a wound from one of the Terminators, and then 2 Raveners were killed. Now they got hit and run and they broke away and have gone down in the valley here. Oh dear, so he's set up now on his turn to try and charge the remainder of the troops there. So again, in another twist, he's got a chance now of wiping out my troops' choices, so I'm not going to be able to pick up the Relic. So game's not over yet. Remember, he's still got this flyer here as well, able to do some damage. And he's still got the Hive Tyrant, his Warlord. So, game's not over. That's the end of the assault phase. We're going to go on now to Tyranny turn 3. Right, Tyranny turn 3. The Morlock is stuck in the combat there with the Terminators. And then coming around the table, the Gaunts have come out of the woods and heading off towards the vehicles. The Hive Tyrant and Tyrant Guard are moving up. Looks like he's going to plow into that Land Raider. So it is a final stand in the middle here, desperately trying to protect ourselves, but there's gaps. The Raveners are in a position to charge the troops' choices there. And then the Winged Hive Tyrant trying to select a target, so many to choose from, but he has decided to swoop in and take on the Death Company. I'm trying to take advantage that we will not get the benefits from the Reclusiarch for charging. So there is opportunity there for him. He's initiative 5, but he wants to throw himself into the Death Company there. So that will be a real showdown. And then he's sneaking some more troops around the Land Raider here. So it's not over yet. Tyranids rolled on the biomancy chart and rolled on warp speed, and they got a 5, which is on a d3, that's 3. So they're on plus 3 initiative, plus 3 attacks with this Hive Tyrant. So it's going to be really messy, and they're saying that they're going to try and challenge the Reclusiarch. So we have a situation now. The Reclusiarch appears like he's going to be doomed. as the Tyranid Hive Tyrant charges in. You could make a film on this scenario. It is a desperate time for the Blood Angels. Will they be able to pick up the relic? It could cost the life of the Reclusia. Where's Brother Kabulo, who's feel no pain? He's miles away up the hillside. There are multiple characters here, and the Winged Hive Tyrant is on the hunt, and he's going to single out the Warlord and try and gain that extra point, which would be helpful for the Tyranid force. If they can deny us picking up the relic, and then they can slay a Warlord, and a little bit more adjustment of their force, they could still pull off a draw or a win. So, and now the Tyranids are actually cheating. They're adding more units onto the table. So, for cheating, we'll have to go and beat them for that. But let's go on now to the assaults for Tyranids on turn 3. Right then, assaults for the Tyranids. The Hive Tyrant goes into the Land Raider and then round the other side. He rolled a 1 and a 2 to charge in, but he does have the fleet rule. So they rerolled that and they've managed to charge in. So that is a matter that goes on. And one here, and then the one on the hillside. 3 interesting and important melees now as the Tyranids try and tip the scales of this game. So we're going to go on and get the results for these assaults. And another assault in the middle. The Raveners have charged the 2 remaining troops choices for the Blood Angels. So that's another melee going on. Right, so it's Morlock versus Terminators. And we're going to do the Morlock first. So let him go here. So off you go. You want 4s to hit. And then so that's 2 hits, and then 2s to wound, double 6, so Terminator's got to make their saves here. Yes, they've passed with their invuns, and then we'll do our assaults. So, Brother Kabulo, he gets his hits there, 5s, oh, we've got a rend with Brother Kabulo on a 6, so the chainsaw goes through, that's 1 wound, and then the Terminator's is 8 attacks, we want 4s. That's not bad. 3s. Oh yes, that's actually 6 hits. 2s to kill. Goodbye, Morlock. Nice clean kill there for the Blood Angels. So Raveners are going to go first here. Now it's a disordered charge because they're charging the 2 remaining units. So, and they'll go first initiative 5. Just going to roll that up now. Just re-rolling with those. And that's good going. No complaints, 15 hits, so we now want some 4s to wound. It would be enough to kill them, but not quite enough. So we're going to roll that for the Blood Angels now. There's 6 saves to make 3 plus. So we'll do 3 on each. So the squad with 2 men left have died. And the squad holding the relic, one has died, so that's nasty. Right, so that's 3 casualties there. So the remaining Marine has got a hit and no wound. And then the Sergeant does have a power weapon, and he's missed. Oh boy. I've lost by 3, so my LD is 6. This is bad. I would probably try and pass. On a double 1, they are not leaving that relic. They're going to stay to the death and hold on to that relic. They've got it for the 3rd time it's been grabbed, and they are not going to let go of it. So that melee continues. The Raveners are on the rampage, killing the Blood Angels Assault Marines, but the melee continues. Right, melee then. We've done over here. The Terminators destroyed the Morlock. Nice clean kill and have rolled a 6. They've moved down the hillside. Then down here, the Raveners killed 3 Marines. We lost the melee, but rolled a double 1 on morale. So we've still got 2 figures in base contact with the relic, although we're stuck in combat now. So it's a sticky situation there. And then his Hive Tyrant has destroyed the Land Raider. So that's gone. So now we've got a situation here where the Winged Hive Tyrant's flown in and has assaulted the Death Company. Now he has, on his initiative of 8, he has challenged the Reclusiarch. So for game purposes, try and win the game, I would refuse that challenge and try and survive to deny him that Slay the Warlord point. But In the true honour and style of the Blood Angels, I will accept the challenge and try and survive his attacks for the Emperor. So he's got a Hammer of Wrath hit, which is just one dice. It's a wound, so we're going to make a save. No, oh dear. So we've worked it out that he gets 8 attacks. 4 attacks, 5 for charging, and then 3 more attacks for his psychic power. So, and he's going to reroll ones. So we reroll that 1. Well, we could be witnessing the death of the Reclusiarch. So, weapon skill, 8. Oh dear. Right, so he's got himself 6 hits, 2s to wound, nice string of 1s would be good. Strength 6, here we go. He's got 1-1, so I've got to make 5 saves. I have got my 4 plus invuln save. So, Reclusiarch here, we need 4s. Come on. Oh dear, Reclusiarch is dead. Right, sorry Reclusiarch, you've got to go. Not tough enough. So the Reclusiarch has died, and then the melee will continue there with the Winged Hive Tyrant. So that's a sad, sad moment for the Blood Angels as the Reclusiarch goes. But let's hope that he has not sacrificed his life in vain, that we'll be able to rescue the relic. One relic is worth a life of a Reclusiarch. So we're going to move on now to Blood Angels turn 4. Can they salvage the situation once again? Right, Blood Angels turn 4. There's not much units left on the table for the Tyranids, really. So it's a final assault from them. This Storm Raven shifted to the right. We're all trying to get a line of sight to try and take on his Warlord, try and kill him off. There's a lot of wounds to get through. It can be done. Now, the Terminators are broken off from Kabulo, and they're going around to wipe out this Gaunt unit coming around the table. You can see the Hive Tyrant there. So this flyer's got a position on him as well. And then looking up, you can see that the Predator Annihilator is looking down on him as well with his supporting fire from the las cannons. Death Company Dreadnought, lovely target. It's going to try and take on the Raveners. And then Brother Kabulo dashing through the smoke and ruins of the burnt out Land Raider, rushing forwards to rescue his brothers from the Raveners. You couldn't have planned it, he couldn't have scripted it better. Here he comes to save the day. Shooting from the Blood Angels, firepower from here and here, and the other Storm Raven has killed the last of the Tyrant Guard and put a wound on the Hive Tyrant, so that's not bad going. And now we're just going to go on to assaults for the Blood Angels, a couple of charges to go in, and then a lot of melees to resolve. Right, combat results then. The Terminators lost a Terminator charging in on the snap fire, would you believe, but they have destroyed. They've actually wiped out the Gaunts there, but Fearless from the Hive Tyrants is continuing melee, frustrating for the Blood Angels. So this combat here, Kabulo's still alive. Death Company Dreadnought, 17 hits on the Raveners, kills, so wipes them out, save the day. It's a good move from the Death Company Dreadnought. And then one Marine left on the Relic. It's the Lone Sergeant, the last troop that we have left. And then the Hive Tyrant there, not touched in combat, then coming across, horrendous casualties on the Death Company from the Hive Tyrant, and only one wound dealt out by the Thunderhammer. So that was a good move, killing off one of the Blood Angels units there. But that's the end of Blood Angels turn 4, going to go on to Tyranid turn 4. Right, not much to do on Tyranid turn 4, not much stuff left. The Hive Tyrants move round. He's going to charge into Kabulo. Kabulo's standing there, going to try and stand up to this evil monster. And then the troops have moved round. The four Gaunts are going to try and move round and assault the last assault marine sergeant. Right, going right to the wire here for what it might do. And then continuing melee there and a continuing melee there. So we're going to get those results now on Tyranid turn four. Right, assault results on turn four for the Tyranids. The Hive Tyrant killed another Death Company. But that melee continues. We didn't get a wound with the Thunder Hammer. And then Brother Kabulo is saying, get back, filth, to the Hive Tyrant. He's standing there. We passed our feel no pains. And that melee continues. The Sergeant shot killed one of the Gaunts. And then he killed another one in combat. But the Gaunts overpowered and killed him. So our troops are gone. The Sergeant is down. And the Relic now is in the hands of the Tyranids. Well, it's kind of just in the middle there. There's still a number of characters around. And then the Terminators killed. The Terminators killed the last Gaunt and have come around 5 inches. Blood Angels turn five. There was no shooting. It was all combats. Terminators charged in to the Hive Tyrant, and in that combat, they've killed him. Kabulo still lives. Death Company Dreadnought charged in to the Gaunts and killed those. And then the Winged Hive Tyrant killed the last of the Death Company is consolidated just into the crater there. So there is one Winged Hive Tyrant left on the table for the Tyranids. That is it. So we're going to go on now to Tyranid turn 5. The game could end at the end of this turn. Right, Tyranid turn 5. The Hive Tyrant, Winged Hive Tyrant's charged into Kabulo. Going to try and take him out. Was unclaimed. Both sides lost all their troops, so no one could claim the relic, so we're going to have to play the mission again one day. But as far as victory points are concerned, first blood to the Blood Angels, and then both sides got Slay the Warlords. The final score is 2-1 to the Blood Angels. Game ends on turn 5.